I was in Canberra very recently, and I got a bit of a theme going there just with pyramids. So in this video, I'll just show that. I'll show a few other bits and pieces as well. And yeah, just a bit of a cruisy sort of a video. Just to say with pyramids that I was told years ago by a high up Freemason that the pyramid represented a light structure. Now, there would surely be other instances to that. When people think of the Illuminati, they often sort of put the pyramid with that, but with the eye, well, the single eye is sort of represented in other cultures, and it also is represented in the Bible, also talked about in the Bible. So to make the claim of evil, yes, it's on the dollar note and all the rest of it, but you'd have the, you know, swastika and the likes on coins and stuff like that. Also, the swastika, for example, wouldn't necessarily be evil. And for those people who sort of link the pyramid just with evil and, oh, pyramid systems and all the rest of it, I certainly question that. But anyway, we'll get into the video. So this is Canberra here with the Parliament House right through here, old in the foreground and new in the background there. And so just looking at the logo on here, though, among other things, so what can we say about the logo?
Well, it definitely has the pyramidal shape. The A's in the word Canberra would be reminiscent of the arches on the top of New Parliament House also. And there's definitely a triangle in there, and maybe even two eyes can be seen in the in the perspective that we have.
Yeah. On here there's the G, and if I'm pointing it to here, what about it?
Yes, it does seem to be of a different font style to the rest of the wordings there. One might suggest that it's a Masonic G that's hidden in plain sight.
Because none of the other letters promenade down, it's got that downstroke to it.
Yes, and one would assume that the Marion Mahoney would have both the M's capitalised also if it were to be an effective capitalization, but no, just the G is different.
Yeah, my battery's almost out.
On 666 ABC.
Just on the shore of Lake Burley Griffin here, and yet another pyramid form here. We're just across from the War Memorial. So that's the plaque right there. And just sort of showing this. This is looking out onto Lake Burley Griffin. We're just going to go across and look at the Carillion right through here. Okay, so we're at the shore of Lake Burley Griffin, which is around here, and just looking, this is the Carillion, and looking straight up, within the triangle here, there is 81 triangles, smaller triangles, and you can see further geometry portrayed within here. The Carillion, being Australia Day, the Carillion is actually being played right now. You can get into it through this door here, and people have come in and out. But nonetheless, there are 55 bells up there also, so another one of these repeat numbers, in this case 55. Up here it's like a kind of heavenly chamber, if you will, with the bells going. You could think of it in that way. Okay, so just looking at the keyhole here, keyhole representation. You've got the compass down here, in a way that's where the War Memorial is. But you can see the pyramid structure in there also. So just looking over here for a moment, and just to repeat, people like looking at this, I quite like it. And you can see in the queue there the little pyramid, and also in the lighting over here you can see the pyramid also. This is the underground car park at the Australian War Memorial, and these pillars are sort of slightly out of place, but just noticing the inverted pyramid on them, there's one here and then there's another sort of greenish one in the back there. The entranceway would be through here. So just an observance here in Canberra.